Today we are in our artichoke patch, and what we're gonna try to find out is how many transplants we can get out of this one. So these are about 3, maybe 4 years old, and you can see how the main one that most likely is already gone. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we're gonna see what we can do to thin these out and transplant them in other parts of the garden. So what we're gonna do is get in here and dig these out. All of this is good for worms or compost or chop and drop. Still got enough roots on it. Some seedlings. There we go. One. Big one. There we go. Nice size. we'll leave these two in there. Since we managed to put in a decent hole here, we're just gonna fill it back up. It's a little bit of soil mix. Looks like we're able to get quite a few. Some nice ones. Yeah. One, two, three, four, five, six, and number seven. And we left two in the ground. Actually, three. Not bad. Put them right in the corner underneath the peach tree. Finish it off. I'm gonna water it in with the worm sauce. About 2 ounces. So what we're doing here is just under the drip line of our desert gold peach, which is fantastically blooming. We're putting a line of artichokes on the southwest facing side of the root mass. So what it's gonna do is once they grow up, they're gonna throw a lot of shade down in the summer in the hottest part of the year. And it'll keep this area nice and cool. And we'll also get quite a bit of just organic matter out of all these leaves. You can keep plucking them off and laying them back down, and it'll continue to feed the soil. Here we are at the front of the house, and as you can see, there's a very large tree, nicely shaped, sitting in the side yard. Unfortunately, it's time for it to go. So all that has been giving me lots of good leaf compost, but the roots are going that way, right underneath the house. And these trees, as they get older, tend to break. And I don't want that thing falling anywhere near my house. There was another one behind there, probably another 20 years older than this one or more, and that one actually fell over in the wind, broke a fence, almost broke a neighbor's trailer. So we'll see what happens tomorrow.